But I think they would be based on American styles of eating. And it will be the Indian touches that go into the American style of eating. So we are all very taken with a burrito. Americans are very taken with the idea of burrito. So I got sticky at chapati and sticky at roti and put it in that form. So I think that's more likely to happen and is happening.
I mean, if you look at Italian food, when Italian food first came to the US, it was, people didn't like it, it was foreign food. And it took almost like the red saucification of Italian food.
Right.
Now everyone makes Italian food.
Right. So I think, I think there's a reason for it. I think for a food to become part of you, another food from another country, but this is no country. It's made up of immigrants, so it's nothing. It starts with what? Like a jelly. Because it's no country. The people who are this country have been pushed aside. They're no longer here, they no longer matter. Their corns and beans matter. We've taken those, but the people don't matter. We've flung them aside. Pretty much as the British did to us. They flung us aside. They love our food. Oh, curry, curry is wonderful. But the people, the natives, we don't care too much about them. So I think the attitude is very similar here, that people love the taste of certain kinds of foods. They're liking hotter and hotter food. That taste is growing. And they say that once you begin to like hot things, there's no going back.
So I had the opposite experience when I was in middle school.
Really?
Yes. I found that people were very accepting of me and of my parents and of the fact that we were Indian. But there was this one girl, her family was from Tamil Nadu, and she brought dosa in to lunch. And people were awful to her about the dosa. They were like, it smells, or you're eating with your hands. And so I feel like Americans have been more accepting of Indians and less accepting of the nuances of our food.
Well, nuances, forget it, you're right. You're absolutely right. But certain aspects of our cuisine, not curry, which they don't understand at all, but I think certain aspects, like they take it to tamarind. Even in the 70s and 80s, when I was starting out, there were chefs, the major chefs, were picking out things like tamarind and cardamom and mustard seeds, and using them the wrong way, like they would make a salad and they would sprinkle mustard seeds on the top. Grow mustard seeds, they have to get crushed, so you have to do something to mustard seeds to make them exciting. In hot oil, or you crush them, but you just don't sprinkle them over lettuce.
Does it drive you crazy when people put like a spoonful of halloumi in their orange juice?
It just still does this to me because raw halloumi is something that. We don't.
Yeah, I don't think people understand that.
No, people
don't
understand that.
Yeah.
So these things have to be explained. So then you tell them, okay, either you roast your spices, or then they roast every spice.
Totally.
Yeah.
And then they think that every Indian dish involves roasting 10 spices.
Yes,
right.
So they go crazy roasting the spices. So I think this whole business is a little too hard.